So starting off, Rookie is just plucking the frontal portion of the wig. This wig is a 360 wig, but we've decided not to pluck the back as I'm not wearing it up. But she's just doing this in little sections and just going through and plucking random portions of the front of the wig. Then she's going to flat comb it. Is it flat comb? No, she's going to use a hot comb to flatten the top of the wig. Then she's just going to try it on my head and then cut off the ear tabs around my ear. So once the ear tabs have been cut off, Rookie's going to start off with the bald cap method. I haven't done this in such a long time, but she's going to use some Got To Be spray all around my hairline with a wig cap on. The wig cap does have to be nude. She sprays all around this quite generously, and then she's going to dry this with a blow dryer, and you have to make sure this is completely dry before moving on to the next portion, otherwise it will just ruin the whole thing. The whole point of the bald cap method is just so your hair can be really, really flat and the frontal portion of the head can look really, really realistic. It's a great method if you want your hair to, if you want your wig to last for a couple of days. So Rookie's just gonna add some foundation on my scalp, not on the scalp, sorry, on the wig cap, just to make it close to my skin tone so it's easier to blend in once the wig has been applied. So she's just doing this all over, and then she's going to cut off the excess wig cap around my head. So the end result is basically making it look like a thumb. Then she's going to get some alcohol and just wipe the excess makeup off that area so the glue adheres a lot easier to my skin. And then she's going to refit the wig and adjust it to begin to apply the wig. So she's going to go in with a little bit more customization around the hairline of my hair, just to fit my personal hairline. And once that's done, she's going to start to apply the glue on the wig cap. I believe this glue is Ghost Bond, but if I'm wrong, I'm going to leave it in the description box. But I do believe it's Ghost Bond glue. She added a few layers because I did tell her I wanted to wear it for a few days. And then after applying those layers, she's going to stick it down on my head. Once that is stuck on my head, she then goes in with some mousse and applies the mousse around the hairline and ties it up ready to style. If you guys haven't noticed, because I haven't actually mentioned this whole time, this wig is from Wow Africa and it is a kinky straight wig. I haven't done kinky straight in the longest time and I just really wanted it because I just feel like it looks so realistic and very, very close to what would be a relaxed hair texture, which I love. So literally, as soon as this hair was done, I fell in love with it. It's so full. One thing I love the most about it is so full, hence Rookie blow drying it for a long time because you're trying to get it as flat as possible. The density on this wig is literally like amazing. You get so much hair and it's super duper full, so realistic, and I absolutely love it. You can obviously style it with hot tools. It doesn't, it is human hair, so it doesn't burn or anything like that. It's just kinky and very close to afro hair. So yeah, so once that's done, after the blow drying, Rookie's just trying to get it as flat as possible. She's just gonna use some wax stick and then use her hot comb in sections and just kind of split the hair and hot comb it so it gets super, super duper flat, which is lovely because I want it to look, you know, really like it's grown out of my scalp. And this technique really does help with that. So yeah, I absolutely love this wig. Like I said earlier, it's from White African. I haven't used their company in such a long time, but I love the quality of the hair. I love the density of the hair. One thing I will say that I wasn't necessarily keen on, but it's obviously preference, I feel like the lace could have been a little bit thinner, not necessarily thinner, but I feel like the color of the lace could have been worked on a little bit more. However, I do like the wig overall, and if you are a professional or if you're gonna get your hair done by a professional, they will be able to fix this, so it's not that much of a biggie. But if you're a first-time wig wearer, you might find this a bit hard. So Rakeem's just going through my hair on the other section, and just making sure it's just super, super duper flat, section by section. I sped this up a lot, but it did take quite some time. But she's literally being very meticulous about how she's doing it. Otherwise, if you don't do the steps properly, it's not going to come out how you want it to look. So I'm glad that she took her time, because it ended up looking so bomb and I was absolutely in love with it. So I'm just gonna shush for a little bit, let Rikki do her thing, and I'm gonna come back in a sec for the second portion of the video. Okay, so now that's all flat, Rikki's just gonna take off the band, and guys, can you see how flat that lace is? Literally looks like my scalp. I freaking loved it. Once I saw the result, I was like, oh my god, I couldn't stop touching my hair. Love it so much. Literally looks like it's growing from my scalp. Looks like my hair, looks like afro hair. I wish my hair was this length. I literally wish my hair was this length, but we're getting there, sis, we're getting there. But yeah, and this is before it's even styled. I'm just gonna give you a little close-up of the lace. Looks so flawless, realistic. The little bits at the front is her literally about to cut some baby hairs, which she's done here. She just cut the baby hairs and she's just using some mousse just to style them a little bit. I don't like too many baby hairs, so I just kind of, we just went for like a natural look, which I love, because Rikki doesn't do too much with that, because I just feel like it looks ridiculous when you have too many baby hairs. But she's just about to go in back with the elastic band so she can start styling again. So we went for some loose waves. I didn't get a clip of this because I don't know, I think something happened to my camera, but she literally just used a wand and just went away from my face with the wand and went for some loose waves. Then here she's trying to get it as flat as possible, just to help it look, you know, a lot more neat. So she just used some spray on her hand and she just kind of like flattened it down with her hands just to make it flat, okay. Then we are done, guys. It was so quick, so easy, and literally looks bomb diggity. I love it so much. You can find out more info about the wig in the description box. Make sure you check it out. If you are a kinky lover like me, you would definitely love this hair. This wig, sorry. It is so versatile, and of course you can wear it up if you pluck the back as well. So yeah, this is the final look. Absolutely love it. Let me know your thoughts down below. Would you try it? Have you tried kinky? What do you think? And hopefully I'll see you guys in another video very soon. Thank you so much to White Africa for sponsoring this video, and I'll see you guys in another video. Bye guys. Mwah.